morning students. Today we are going to start data handling. It's a very interesting chapter and you have also seen some of the topics related to data handling in your previous classes. Now let us see what actually data is. Data is the collection of specific information, not any information. It should be specific. Suppose I want to collect the data of different age groups. So we have to see only age groups of that particular area. We don't have to see the height and other things. So it is known to be collection of specific information. Now let us see one of the most important topic after data is organization of data. Once we collect the data, organization is one of the most important thing that we need to do. To organize the data, we arrange them either in ascending or descending order. Unless they are arranged, we are not able to organize them, or we are not able to conclude any information from those data. Now let us see some examples. For example, weight of 5 students of your class is. Suppose weight of one student is 30, then 45, then 35, then 41 and 34. I have collected the data randomly. You can choose the weight of your class. So here let us define what the data specific here is. So the data specific here is weight of the students, and let us organize this data. To organize the data, we have to arrange them in ascending order, that is smaller to bigger, 30, 34, 35, 41 and 45 kgs. So here we can add one more term, that is range. What actually range is? Range is the difference between the smaller and the bigger one. Okay. So here the range is 45, that is the highest weight minus lowest weight. So here the range is 15 kg. Okay. So we will not write the unit here. Now come to next topic, that is arithmetic mean or average mean. These all are same terms. You may either say arithmetic mean, or you may say average, or you may say mean. All are same terms. So average you have studied in your earlier classes. Now we are going to see the arithmetic mean and mean. Okay, so it is defined as sum of all observations of all the data that you have collected upon number of observations. The data you have collected from different person or anything like that, it must specify the number. So let us take one example. For example, a batsman scored the following number of runs in 6 innings. These are the runs scored by a batsman: 42, 50, 55, 60, 36 and 45. Now the question is, we need to calculate the mean runs scored by him in an inning. Okay, that means we have to find the mean of the given data. So the total runs scored is, let us first add all of them because we need to find the mean. So after adding this, we get it as to 88. And now how many innings are there? There are 6. So the mean will be total upon number of innings. So it will be 48. Hence, mean runs scored in an inning are 48. Now here one thing you have to keep in mind. Whenever you find the average or mean, it will always lie between the highest and the lowest value. Okay, it should be in between them. Otherwise, your answer will be wrong. Now let us see one more example. It's a good question. Find at least 5 numbers between 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. Two rational numbers are given, and two fractions are given, and we have to find 5 numbers between them. So for finding them, what we will do? We can take, find the mean, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 divided by 2. So after solving this, we get it as one of the number between 1 by 2 and 1 by 3 is 5 by 12. This is one of the number. Like this, we have to find 4 more numbers. Now let us find the number between 1 by 2 and 5 by 12, again we will find the mean, and your answer will be, in this case, it will be 11 by 24. So one of the number, now you here you can see, one of the number between 1 by 5, 2 and 5 by 12 is 11 by 24. And similarly, we will find the mean between 5 by 12 and 1 by 3, it will be 9 by 24. So here two more numbers are left. So you can choose any two numbers and find the mean between them, and that will be the average of that number. Okay. So in this way, you have to solve. Hence, we see that the five numbers are 11 by 24, 21 by 48, 5 by 12, 19 by 48 and 9 by 24. Now let us see the exercise. Let us start the exercise of NCERT. Here, first question is based on your class. So you have to collect the data from your class. That's why I have skipped the question. Let us do question number 2. Here given numbers are, this is the data given. Okay, here the data is quite large. Now let us count the data of how many numbers are given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20. So let us arrange them, organize the data, arrange them in ascending order. Once you arrange them in ascending order, we can easily find highest number is 9, lowest number is 1. And thus what will be the range? 9 minus 1, that is 8. 8 will be the range. Now next step we need to find is find the arithmetic mean. So find the sum of all the numbers, and 20 numbers are there, so it will be 100 by 20. So the arithmetic mean is 5. You can also solve such type of question by using tally mark, so that no doubt is there. Okay, so that none of the number is skipped. In tally marks you can easily check your data whether you have written all the numbers or not. 1 is appearing one time, 2 is appearing two times, 3 is appearing one time, 4 is appearing three times, 5 is appearing five times, 6 is appearing four times, 7 is appearing two times, 8 is appearing one time, and 9 is appearing one time. So once you add the frequencies, okay, these are known as frequency, how many times they have appeared. If we are getting 20, that means our data is right. Now let us do next, that is mean of first 5 whole numbers we need to find. Whole numbers start from 0. So to find the mean of these 5 whole numbers, we will add them. 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So sum of the observations, we get 10. And how many numbers are there? 5. So the mean is 2. Now let us see next 5th question. It's a very interesting question. Here the question is, 3 players are there, A, B, C, and all the 3 players played 4 games, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The data is given here. Okay, now here C skipped game 3rd because it is written in the table, did not play. Now what we need to find, we have to find the sum of all the scores of player A. So what you will do, you will add all the scores of player A. Then after that, we see that we are getting 50, and so mean will be, since they played 4 games, so it will be 50 by 4, that is 12.5. Now come to second part. It has been asked that C player played how many games? We have to divide it by 3 because he played only 3 games. Player C played only 3 games. So to find the mean, we will divide it by 3. Now mean of B, in the same way we need to do, sum up all the runs, divide it by total number of games. The mean we are getting in terms of decimal. Okay. Now it has been asked in the 4th part, who is the best performer? We can easily see that the mean of A is maximum, so A is the best performer. Now question number 6 is, marks obtained by a group of students are given like this. So based on this data, we have to find certain number of questions. So first thing what we need to do is arrange them in ascending order. This is the ascending order, Now highest marks obtained is 95, lowest marks obtained is 39. It is due to the arrangement of data, it becomes easier to write down highest and lowest marks. Now to find the range, we will find the difference between highest and lowest marks. Now mean marks will be sum of all marks divided by 10. So the mean is 73. Now come to next question number 8. Days are given, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 days are given and the average rainfall in millimeter is given. Based on this data, we need to find range of the rainfall. Highest is 20.5, lowest is 0. So the range of this rainfall will be 20.5. Now mean rainfall for the week will be, add up all the rainfall divided by 7, because there are 7 days. So the mean rainfall is 5.9 mm. Now for 5 days, we have to see for how many days the rainfall was less than the mean rainfall. We can easily see from the table that average is 5.9. So you can see for how many days the range was less, mean was less, 0.0, 2.1, 0.0, then 1, then 5.5. These are the 5 days on which the rainfall was less. Now next topic is mode. To find the mode of a set of observation is the observation that occur most often, most frequently. For example, find the mode of the given set of numbers. The given set of numbers are here. You arrange them in ascending order. Now here we see that 12 is occurring 3 times, 14 is occurring 2 times, and all other numbers are 1 time. So most frequently the number 12 is occurring. So the mode of this data will be 12. Okay. If we need to find the mode of large data, what we will do? Here see, you can see the example, height in centimeter of 25 children are given below. So we have to find mode of this, their heights. So for this, the best way to find the mode is arrange, make a tally marks table. Okay, you can make a tally mark table and again 160, 161 like this. And what we see here that 163 is occurring most frequently. The frequency of 163 is maximum. So the mode of this data is 163 centimeter. Now come to next topic, median. Here median refers to the value which lies in the middle of the data, whether we arrange them in an increasing or decreasing order. That means half of the observation should be on the left side, half of the observation should be on the right side. Okay. Let us take one example. Find the median of the given data. Here the data is given. First thing that you need to do, maybe to find the mode, maybe to find the median, we have to arrange them. So after arranging them in ascending order, how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 numbers are there. It's an odd number. So the median will be the middlemost term. That is 35. Okay. Three numbers are lying on the left side. 3 numbers on the right side. So the middlemost term is 35. If you are not arranging them in ascending order, your answer will be wrong. Now let us start the exercise. Here the data is given. Now it has been asked to find the mode and median both. So first thing, without any wastage of time, we will arrange them in ascending order. So here we see that to find the mode, we have to see the number which is occurring most frequently. So here 20 is repeated maximum number of time, so the mode is 20. And of course there are how many numbers we need to count? The middlemost term will be the median. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. So 15 terms are there. So the middle most term will be 20. Here the middle most term will be 20. So the median is 20. Now come to next. Next question is, the weight in kg of 15 students of the class are given. Again we will arrange them in ascending order. Now maximum, here one thing that you have to note, that there can be more than one mode of the given data. Here 38 and 43 are repeated same number of times, okay, and it is maximum. So both are the mode of the given data, and the middle most term will be the median, okay. So here we have two mode. Now the last question of this exercise is to find true, to tell true or false. The question is, the mode is all, the statement is, the mode is always one of the numbers in the data. Yes, mode will always be one selected number, so it is true. The mean is one of the numbers in the data. No, we have seen the mean can be in terms of decimal also, so it is false. Next is, the median is always one of the numbers in the data. Yes, true, because it is the middle most term. The data has mean 9. So for this you will calculate it, arrange, you will add all the numbers, divide it by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, and we see that mean is not 9. Okay, now let us start next topic, bar graph. Actually, what do you mean by bar graph? It is the representation of numbers using bars or rectangles of equal widths. If they are not equal, then your graph will be wrong. And the next topic here is double bar graph. It helps to compare two collections of data at a glance. Once you see the graph, and if it is double bar, you can easily compare the data. Okay, you few points you need to keep in mind while plotting a bar graph. Always title of the graph should be there, scale of the graph should be there, horizontal line is the x-axis, vertical line is the y-axis. Specification along x and y axis should be always be written, what you actually want to represent along x axis, what you actually want to represent along y axis, and the bars you are plotting should be of equal width. The space between the bars should be equal. Now let us start the exercise. Question number one is, the graph is given like this, okay. Now based on this graph, here let us see, discuss the points that we have to keep in mind. Here title is written, pets owned by students, scale is given, 1 square centimeter is 2 students. Now along the vertical line, number of students are given, and along the x-axis, horizontal line, pets are given, and the data is already shared. So now we have to, by looking into the graph, we have to tell which is the most popular pet. From the graph it is clear that the maximum number of students have cat as the pet animal, so cat is the most popular pet. And how many dogs, how many students have dogs as a pet? So from the graph, 8 students have dogs as a pet. Now come to next. Now again the graph is given, based on that graph we have to answer some of the question. From the graph, in 1989 number of books sold were 175. You can see the graph, in 1990 475, in 1992 it is 225. Okay, we have to consider it as approx. And similarly second part you can see here, third part also you can see here, fourth part it's a little bit typical. Here it is given that how you have identified that the as approximation is 175. So here the justification is there, length of the bars in the air 1989 is approximately 1.75. okay, now the scale given is 1 centimeter is 100 books. So the number of books estimated to be sold in 1989 will be 1.75 this centimeter multiplied by 100 books. So it will be 175 books. Now in question number 3, we have to plot the graph. Okay, we need to plot the graph. This is the graph. Here title is number of children in 6 different classes. Scale is selected. 1 centimeter is 10 children. Okay, and the graph is being plotted. Okay, these are the graphs. Now let us see, based on this graph we have to answer some of the question. What is the scale chosen? 1 square centimeter is 10 children. Now which class has the maximum number of children? From the graph it is clear 5th class has maximum, 10th class has minimum. Now next is to find the ratio of the students of class 6 to class 8. We have seen it is 6.5. okay, now next is to plot the double bar graph. Again in double bar graph we can easily see along x the title is given, performance of student, scale is given 10 marks, along horizontal line subjects are given, along vertical line maximum marks are given, and the scales are chosen. For green color we have written it displays first term, brown color displays second term, and thus it will represent the graph. The next is, based on this, the child improved his performance the most in the subject of maths. There was a difference, quite large difference, between first term and second term. Second part is, the improvement is least in the subject of social science. The difference was minimum. And third part was, has the performance gone down? Yes, in Hindi subject we see that the subject performance has gone down. Now last topic of this chapter is chance and probability. So what actually chance is? It's a new term for you all. So chance predicts a possibility, and from this we can define probability. Probability is number of favorable cases upon total number of cases. We can see from here, probability is always denoted by a capital P, and it always lies between 0 and 1. If the probability is 0, that means it's an impossible event, and if the probability is 1, that means it's a sure event. We will see various examples for this. For example, the best example is when we throw a dice. So probability of getting a number 7. A dice has 6 faces and we can get only numbers from 1 to 6. So the probability of getting 7 here is impossible event. Now next example is probability of getting natural number between 1 and 6. Definitely the numbers are from 1 to 6. So it's a sure event. Next case is the probability of getting green light in traffic. Once you go out from your home, the probability of getting green light in traffic, it may happen but not always sure. So it's uncertainty is there. We cannot definitely say that what will happen. So it's an uncertain event. Now next is probability of getting head while tossing a coin. Probability of getting head as well as tail both is 1/2, because the total outcomes when you toss a coin, either you will get head or you will get tail. So the total outcomes are 2, and the favorable case for head is 1. So it will be 1/2. Similarly, for favorable case for tail is again 1, and total outcome is 2. So the probability is 1/2. Now next is probability of getting even numbers while throwing a dice. You know that a dice has 6 faces, so the numbers that you can get are 6. Now even numbers are 2, 4 and 6. 3 even numbers are there, so the probability of getting even number is 3/6. In lowest form it is 1/2. Again for odd number it is same, 1/2. Now come to the exercise. Now the statements are given, we have to identify which type of event is it. The first statement is, you are older than today than yesterday. Definitely it is certain to have happen. Every day we are getting older. Next is, a tossed coin will land heads up. It can happen but not certain. We are not sure whether head will come or tail will come. So it can happen but not certain. Third part is a die when tossed shall land up with 8 on the top. We know that a die has only 6 faces, so we cannot get 8, so it's an impossible event. The next traffic light seen will be green. Again, it can happen but not certain. Next is tomorrow will be a cloudy day. It can happen but not certain. We are not sure that it will rain. Now question number 2 is 6 marbles are there in a bag and the number 1 to 6 are written over there. So the total outcomes of the marble are 6. Now we need to find the probability of drawing marble with number 2. We see that a number 2 is appearing only one time, so the probability of drawing a marble with number 2 will be 1/6. Okay. Similarly, probability of drawing a marble with number 5, it is also 1/6. 5 number will appear only one time. Now last question is total outcome of tossing a coin. It's 2. So probability of getting head as well as tail both will be 1/2. So the probability that our team will start is 1/2. Thank you, students.